안녕하십니까?
Hello everyone.
뉴욕에서 너무 행복한 시간들을 보내고 있습니다.
Oh, we're having such a joyful time in New York.
여러분 기쁘십니까?
Everyone, are you happy?
예, 기쁨은 불행을 이깁니다.
Everyone, joy defeats misery.
그리고 슬픔도 이기고요.
It also defeats sadness.
절망도 이기고요.
It defeats despair.
여러분 마음에 기쁨을 많이 쌓아두면 좋습니다.
And it's good to stack up lots of joys in your hearts.
저희들은 여러분 마음에 기쁨과 평안을 쌓도록 마음을 쏟고 있습니다.
And we are pouring our hearts into having you store up joy and peace in your hearts.
그라시아스가 여러분에게서 밑바닥까지 다 드러내는 것 같았어요.
You know, the gracias, you know, they're showing you all they've got for you.
오늘 오전에 너무 이상한 음악 들었죠.
This morning, we just listened to very strange music, right?
난 돈키호테 음악 처음 들었습니다.
You know, it's my first time listening to the music of Don Quixote.
너무 좋지요.
Very good, right?
혹시 여러분도 돈키호테 되어본 적 있어요?
Have you ever become the Don Quixote yourself?
아, 여러분 되게 부끄러워하시는 것 같습니다.
Don't be embarrassed.
오늘은 요한복음 5장에 있는 말씀 좀 읽습니다.
Today we'll read from the words of John chapter 5.
성경 가시면 요한복음 5장을 한번 펴 주시.
If you have your Bibles, please open to John chapter 5.
5장 1절부터요.
John chapter 5 from verse 1.
5절까지 박방 목사님 읽겠습니다.
We'll read John chapter 5, verses 1 through 9. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first after the troubling of the water stepped in, was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie, and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he saith unto him, Wilt thou be made whole? The impotent man answered him, Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another steppeth down before me. And Jesus saith unto him, Rise, take up thy bed, and walk. And immediately the man was made whole, and took up his bed, and walked, and on the same day was the Sabbath.
옛날에 아프리카에서는 사람이 상처가 나면은 몸의 상처 거기 다 썩은 나무 껍질을 갖다 덮었어요.
There was a place in Africa a long time ago when a person would get hurt, they would put rotten tree barks on that person's wound.
근데 그게 무슨 이유인지 모르지만
And we didn't know why
상처가 나서 막 이렇게 피부가 막 벗겨지고 막 상처가 났을 때 썩은 나무 껍질을 갖다 덮으면 병이 너무너무 잘 낫는 거예요.
And so when the person had a cut or a wound on his skin, and then when they put the rotten tree barks on that wound, they would heal very well.
아프리카에서는 사람 상처 나면 항상 썩은 나무 껍질을 갖다가 덮곤 했습니다.
And so at that place in Africa, wherever a person would get a wound, they would put the tree barks on his
과학자들이
wound.
과학자들이 왜 그런지 그걸 연구하다가 연구가 또 중단이 됐습니다.
And the scientists studied why that was, and then they stopped their studies.
1928년경에 플레밍이라는 사람이 있는데요. 플레밍.
1928. There was a person named Fleming.
이 사람이 그 포도 상규균이라고 하는 감염을 일으킨 그 병균을 연구하고 있어요.
And so he was studying this germ. It's very contagious.
그래가지고 그 이제 포도 상규균을 키우고 있었는데.
And then he was growing it.
이상하게 거기에 푸른 곰팡이가 날라와서 거기 떨어졌어요.
And then a blue piece of a fungus landed on it.
아, 그 굉장히 행운 일이었는데.
And then it was very lucky that that happened.
이상한 것은 그 푸른 곰팡이가 그 포도 상규균을 전부 다 죽이는 거예요.
And so what he discovered was that that blue fungus was destroying all the germs there.
그래서 프레밍이 제일 먼저 그걸 연구해 가지고 소위 말하는 페니실린이라는 걸 연구했어요.
And so the person named Fleming studied this and he developed what we called penicillin.
원래 페니실린이라는 말은 돈의 그 단위였는데.
And so penicillin, it was a unit of money, monetary unit.
페니하고 실링이에요. 페니 실링.
The penny and shilling, penicillin.
그게 이제 2차 대전 중에 강하게 연구가 돼가지고.
And so the research was very intense for this during the Second World War.
푸른 곰팡이가 그 포도 상기균을 죽이는데 큰 역할을 한다는 걸 알았어요.
And so they discovered that the fungus was very good at destroying the germs.
2차 대전 때 전쟁에 굉장히 많은 상처를 입었는데.
And so a lot of people got hurt during the Second World War.
이제 그 연구를 아주 활발하게 진행을 했어요.
And then they were very intensely studying this research.
지금 이제 소위 말하는 항생제라는 것을 개발하게 된 거예요.
And through this, that's how they were able to develop antibiotics.
항생제가 처음에 시작된 것은 이제 그 포도상기균을 죽이기 위한 푸른 곰팡이에서 시작이 됐어요.
And so to destroy those germs and the fungus that got into that lab to destroy those germs, that's how the study for the antibiotics began.
이제 뭐 페니실린이 이제 개발되면서.
And so as penicillin became developed,
굉장히 많은 그 항생제들이 나왔어요.
Nowadays there are so many kinds of antibiotics.
소위 최근에 뭐 테라마이신 하는 그런 약.
They have some medicine called teramycin.
테라마이신은 이제 뭡니까? 키로,
메가,
기가,
기가,
테라,
테라.
그래 내시니까 동그라미가 12개 붙나.
So it's four of them, so it's 12 zeros.
그런 이제 효과가 있는 이제 그 항생제입니다.
And so such strong, effective antibiotics.
물론 항생제 그동안 굉장히 많이 이렇게 새로운 막 그 항생제 뭐면 세균도 나왔고 항생제 전쟁을 많이 하고 있어요.
And during that time, many new germs came about, and also many new antibiotics came out to fight them.
옛날에는 상처 안 하면 다리를 끊어야 했고.
Long time ago, when people got wounds, they had to amputate their legs or amputate their arms.
죽어야 했는데.
And people had to die.
페니실린 항생제가 나타나면서 굉장히 많은 사람이 살았어요.
But since the coming of the penicillin, it saved many people's lives.
요즘 항생제 너무 남용해서 문제가 많다고 얘기해요.
Nowadays, you know, penicillin or antibiotics are overused, and that's
the problem.
여러분들도
거의 대부분 항생제 한두 차례 먹고 그렇죠.
And I'm sure most of you has taken antibiotics once or twice, right?
그게 이제 그 썩은 나무 껍질에 있는 푸른 곰팡이 연구하다가 그런 결과까지 오게 된 거예요.
And so they studied the blue fungus on the tree barks, and this is the end result they came up with.
사람들은 지금 우리가 살고 있는 지구의 모든 걸 다 알고 있다고 생각하는 사람이 참 많은데.
There's a lot of people who think that they know everything that's happening in this world.
우리가 모르는 것들이 너무너무 많아요.
But there are so many things that we do not know.
우리가 지금까지 알고 있던 상식이 틀린 것도 굉장히 많이 발견했고.
And we discovered that a lot of the knowledge that we've had till now are wrong.
그러면서 이제 우리 인간들이 점점 과학이 발달해 가기 시작했어요.
And through it, you know, the people's science, it develops more and more.
아주 이제 편리한 많은 일들이 개발됐어요.
And many things were developed that made our lives very convenient.
제가 그런 글들도 읽어보고 많은 것을 우리가 보았지만.
And so I read about these things and we hear about these kinds of things.
근데 마음의 세계에 대해서 정확히 정의를 내린 책들은 찾을 수가 없었어요.
But we cannot find books that speak clearly about the world of the heart.
1962년부터 성경을 읽기 시작했어요.
I began to read the Bible from 1962.
이 성경은 진짜 놀라운 책이에요.
And the Bible is truly an amazing book.
성경이 그냥 한 번 두 번 읽어도 잘 이해가 안 갔습니다.
When we read the Bible just once or twice, I couldn't understand it.
제가 한국어서 약 1,800 페이지가 되는데.
And the Korean Bible is about 1,800 pages.
제가 이 성경을 한번 읽어 60시간 정도가 아니면 읽을 수가 있어요.
And to read the whole Bible once, it takes me about 60 hours.
하루에 10시간씩 성경을 읽으면.
And if you read the Bible 10 hours a day,
제가 6일이면 성경 한번 읽을 수 있고.
I could finish the whole Bible in 6 days.
1년이면 성경 한 50번 정도 읽을 수 있어요.
And in one year, I could read the Bible about 50 times.
한 성경 한 10번쯤 읽었을 때.
But after reading the Bible about 10 times,
깜짝 놀란 건.
I was completely shocked.
이건 마음의 세계를 이야기하고요.
Ah, this is talking about the world of the heart.
그런데 성경이 그냥 하나의 책이었는데.
And before, when I read the Bible was just a book.
이제 성경이 나에게 이야기하기 시작했어요.
And now the Bible began to speak to me.
성경이 창세기를 보면
As I read Genesis.
처음 시작이 이렇게 돼요.
It starts like this.
대체 하나님 천지를 창조하신.
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth.
땅이 온도나 공허함에 허감이 깊음 위에 있고.
The earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep.
운행하신.
And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters.
아무 생각 없이 그거를.
And I read those words thoughtlessly.
하나님한테 빛이 있으면 빛이 있었고.
And then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light.
그 빛이 하나님 보시기에 좋았다.
And God saw that the light was good.
아, 그랬구나.
Oh yeah, I guess so.
성경을 한 번 읽고 두 번 읽고 열 번 읽고 스무 번 읽고.
But I read the Bible once, twice, 10 times, 20 times.
근데 놀랍게도 성경에서 인간을 표현할 때 땅이라고 하는 단어를 통해서 표현한 걸 봤어요.
But amazingly, I discovered that in the Bible, whenever he wanted to express about man, God used the earth.
하나님은 인간을 흙을 가지고 인간의 몸을 만들었다고.
God says God made man from the dust of the earth.
우리 몸은 흙으로 돌아간다고.
And God says that the body will return to the dust of the earth.
그냥 성경 잘 몰랐는데.
And before I didn't know this about the Bible.
성경에서 여러분 인간을 흙으로 땅으로 표현한대.
But throughout the Bible, man is often expressed as the ground, the dirt, the earth.
그러면서 여러분 이 성경이 내 마음에 마음을 일으키는 일을 시작해.
And from then on, the Bible began to lift my heart up.
땅이 혼돈하고 공허하고 허감의 깊음이었어.
The earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep.
땅이 혼돈하고 깊은 허감 속에 있었는데.
The earth was without form and void, and in deep darkness.
땅이 무슨 수단으로 혼돈해서 공허해서 허감에 벗어날 수 있을까?
What could the earth do to be freed from the darkness, from the emptiness, from the shapelessness?
성경학자들은 이야기를 합니다.
Biblical scholars say,
땅이 혼돈하고 공허하고 허감 속에 있는 게 몇 년이 됐느냐?
How many years was the earth without form and void and in deep darkness?
5천만 년.
50 million years.
3억 년.
Or 300 million years.
대부분의 학자들은 근거 있는 얘기가 아니고 추측해서 이야기를 합니다.
And then biblical scholars don't have evidence; they just speak from their assumptions.
실제로 정확하게 이야기하면,
you know, but to say precisely,
땅 자체가 어둠을 물리치만 능력이 전혀 없어.
The earth itself had no power at all to defeat the darkness.
땅이 무슨 일을 해서 어둠을 물리치겠어?
You know, what could the earth do to defeat the darkness?
전혀 없어.
There was nothing you could do at all. How could the earth defeat the darkness? And God said, let there be light. And there was light. God said, there let there be light, and there was light. In other words, God said, let there be light. And there was light. Also saying, the darkness is gone. It means the same thing.
맞습니까?
Is that right?
아, 내 마음에 어둠이.
Ah, the darkness in my heart.
내 노력으로 절대로 물리칠 수가 없구나.
I could never get rid of this through my own efforts.
그다음부터 저는 제 속에 많은 어려움이나 문제를 닥칠 때가 있어.
And from then on, I faced lots of problems and difficulties or sin.
그래서 내가 거기서 번하고 발버둥을 쳐봤어.
And before I would struggle to get out of these things.
안 됐어요.
But I failed.
근데 내가 하나님의 말씀이 내 마음에 비치면서.
But as the word of God shined upon my heart,
그런 문제들이 해결되는 걸 많이 경험.
I experienced these problems becoming taken care of.
그리고 다음에 또 내가 신기한 것이 하나 있습니다.
And after that, there was another something amazing.
하나님 뭐라고 말씀하셨냐면,
What God said was,
땅은 종이로 씻어진 채로 열매는 과목을 내는 거예요.
Let the earth bring forth herb-yielding seed and fruit-yielding seed.
그러니까 여러분 땅에서 싹이 나고 꽃이 피고 열매를 맺는.
And so the earth would bring forth seed, the seed would sprout, grow, and bear fruits.
제가 그거를 읽으면서 너무 감격.
And as I read those words, I felt so touched.
야 하나님 우리 인간에게 꽃을 피우게 하셨구나.
Ah, God is having us man bloom flowers.
우리 인간에게 열매를 맺는 기회를 주셨구나.
And God is giving us the opportunity to bear fruit.
이게 그냥 망상같이 느껴지는 게 실제 내 마음에 와닿는.
And so this did not feel like some dream. It felt real to my heart.
내 마음에 뜨거웠던 게 뭐냐면.
And so what really touched my heart was,
아니면 다이아몬드를 보고,
you know, God didn't say to the diamond,
너 다이아몬드 잘생겼으니까 꽃을 피우고 열매 맺어와.
Hey, diamond, you know, you're beautiful, so you bloom flowers and you bear fruit.
말씀하지 않아.
You know, God did not say that.
아니, 황금을 보고, 넌 꽃을 피우고 열매를 맺어 그랬어요?
God, did God tell the gold to bloom flowers and bear fruit?
아니에요.
No.
아니, 사파이어나 에메랄드 보고 꽃을 피우고 열매를 맺었어요.
Did God tell the sapphire or the emerald to bloom flowers and bear fruit?
아니, 그렇게 말씀하지 않아요.
God did not say such.
사파이어, 에메랄드, 황금, 다이아몬드 전부 값지고 귀한 것.
You know, sapphire, emerald, you know, gold. These are all precious jewels.
가장 천한 흙덩어리를 보고.
But to the most low pile of dirt.
꽃을 피고 열매를 맺으라.
God told it to bloom flowers and bear fruit.
생각을 해봤어.
I thought about it.
만일 지구가
suppose the earth
다이아몬드로 덮였다면
was all covered in diamond. How nice that would be.
얼마나 좋았겠어, 그죠?
How great that would be.
죄송해, 좀 더 굶어 죽지 뭐.
I'm sorry, but we'd all starve to death.
맞습니까?
Is that true?
굶어 죽어요.
We'd all starve to death.
다이아몬드를 가루를 만들어 가지고 산에 쌓아놓고 사과나무 심어요.
Suppose you had a bunch of diamond, you made it into powder and made a big old pile of it and planted an apple tree there.
살아요, 죽어요.
Would it live or die?
죽어요.
It would die.
그럼 여러분 황금은 산에 쌓아놓고 사과나무 사면 심어 죽어요. 살아요.
Suppose you had a pile of gold and planted an apple tree there, would it live or die?
죽어요.
It would die.
사파이어는?
What about sapphire?
에메랄드.
Emerald.
크리스탈.
Crystal.
다 죽어요.
They would all die.
근데 가치 없게 생긴 이 흙은?
But this worthless dirt.
신기하게 씨를 심으면 싹이 나요.
Amazingly, you sow the seed, it sprouts.
신기하게 꽃이 피요.
And it blooms flowers.
열매가 맺어요.
And it bears fruit.
놀라웠어요.
It was amazing.
제가 성경을 읽으면서
as I read the Bible,
하나님이 땅을 이야기해도 흙을 우리를 이야기한다는 얘기.
I realized when God is talking about the earth, the dirt, he's talking about us.
그렇다면
if so,
하나님 나에게 꽃을 피우고 열매 맺는 직분을 줬구나.
Then God has given me the duty to bloom flowers and bear fruit.
가슴이 떨리기 시작했어.
My heart started to tremble.
황금에게 주지 않은
something he did not give to the gold.
다이아몬드 주지 않은
something he did not give to the diamond.
그 직분을 제게 주시겠다 마음이 들어.
That position he gave to me.
성경 안에 들어가면 들어갈수록
the deeper you enter into the Bible,
이제 어디 없던 지혜가 그 안에 있고
in it is the wisdom you cannot find anywhere else.
능력이 그 안에 있고
there's power within it.
그리고 그 안에 사랑이 있고 평안이 있고
and there's love and there's peace inside of it.
꽃이 피고
and flowers bloom and it bears fruit.
제가 지난달에
last month
우간다 대통령을 만났어요.
I met with the president of Uganda.
우간다 대통령 전에 몇 차례 만났는데.
And I met with the president of Uganda several times.
이번엔 IYF 일로 만났어요.
And this time we talked about the IYF.
우간다 대통령께서 이런 얘기했어요.
And the president of Uganda said this to me.
우리 우간다는 땅이 참 비옥하고 넓다.
Uganda has fertile, vast lands.
아프리카의 어느 나라보다도 많은 아프리카 굶는 나라, 우리나라는 굶는 사람이 거의 없다.
And so many countries in Africa have a shortage of food, but there's plenty of food in Uganda.
그리고 지하 자원도 굉장히 많고.
And there are lots of minerals.
그리고 빅토리아 호수에 있어서.
And because of the Victoria Lake.
수산 자원도 참 많아서.
And so they have lots of, you know, fishery.
근데
but the president of Uganda said to me,
젊은이들의 마음이 좋지 않다.
The hearts of the young people are not good.
젊은이들의 마음만 바뀌면
once we change the hearts of the young people
우간다가 정말 천국이 될 것 같다.
Then Uganda will become like heaven.
저를 부르셨어요.
So he called me.
그날 대통령하고 연담을 했습니다.
And that day I had a meeting with the president.
우간다의 젊은이들에게 어떻게 교육할 걸 이야기했어요.
And I told him how we would educate and lead the youths of Uganda.
각하 저는 그냥 적당히 일하고 싶지 않습니다.
I told him, Your Excellency, I don't want to do this half-heartedly.
저는 앞으로 10년 안에
From for this in 10 years from now,
우간다 모든 청소년을 바꾸는 그런 계획을 일하고 싶어요.
I want to work with the plan to change all the youths of Uganda.
첫 번째로 저에게 일할 수 있는 넓은 땅을 주십시오.
Now first, they give me a big piece of land to work for the youths of Uganda.
거기다 건물을 지어서 청년 교육하는 일을 하겠어요.
And we're going to build a building there to educate the youths of Uganda.
건물 지을 동안 한 천 명이 들어갈 수 있는 건물을 주십시오.
And while we're building that, give us a building that fits like 1,000 people.
그동안 일을 하겠습니다.
And we will work for them.
우리는 초등학교 학생들부터 교육을 시작해야 하는데.
And we have to start this education with elementary school kids.
그런데 지금 대학생부터 교육을 시작했어.
And but right now we've begun this education for the college
2차적으로
students.
2차적으로 우리가 학교 교사들 전부 교육을 시키고.
And secondly, we want to train all of your school teachers.
그리고 3차적으로 우리는 정말 마인드 전문 교사들을 만들어내.
And thirdly, we want to bring forth mind lecture specialists.
거기까지 우리는 4년이라는 시간이 소요될까.
And that doing that will take about 4 years.
나머지는 이제 그 교사들이 우간다 청소년들에게 마인드 세계를 가르치도록 하겠습니다.
And after that, we want to have the Ugandan teachers teach the young people there about the world of the heart.
거기에 대한 모든 경비는 우간다 정부에서 담당해 줘야 합니다.
And the Ugandan government should cover all the expenses for this.
대통령께서 말씀하셨습니다.
And then the president said,
한 번 더 여기 올 수 있느냐?
Can you come here one more time?
담당자들하고 이야기하고 싶어요.
You know, I want to have you meet with the people in charge.
교육부 장관,
the minister of education,
거기에 속한 많은 그 상 담당자들을
and the many educators who belong who work there.
두 번째 이제 대통령 만났습니다.
And I had the second meeting with the president.
저는 제가 선교에서 배운 이야기를 사람들에게 이야기했어요.
And so I told people about what I learned from the Bible.
땅이 혼돈하고 공허하고 검이 깊음 속에 있을 때
When the earth was without form and void and in deep darkness,
어떤 방법으로도 무슨 노력을 해도 어둠은 물리칠 수.
The effort, no matter the earth, no matter what it did, no matter what effort it made, it could not be free from the darkness.
그 말씀이 사실인 걸 확인해.
And I discovered that the words of the Bible is the truth.
참 많은 사람이 고통에서 어둠에 절망에 버둥을 발버둥을 치.
And many people, they strain to be free from the darkness, from the pain, from the misery.
여러분, 미국은 어떤지 모르겠지만,
I don't know about the United States.
한국에서는 수면제 파는 양이 굉장히 늘어나고 있어요.
But in Korea, the sales of sleeping pills is rising and rising.
얼마 전에 저희들 어떤 부인이 교회를 처음 나왔어요.
Recently, there was a lady who started coming to my church.
이 사람은 20대 초반에
She, in her early 20s,
수십억을 번 아주 부자였어요.
She made millions of dollars. She was very rich.
이 부인이 갑자기 돈을 많이 버니까.
And all of a sudden, she made a lot of money.
이제 그 돈을 가지고 자기를 즐겁게 하고 싶었어요.
And with that money, she wanted to make herself happy.
돈을 무지무지하게 버니까.
And she made a tremendous amount of money.
돈 버는 사람들이 모여 노는 세계가 있어.
And there is a world where people with lots of money come in and play.
여러분 즐겁게 하고 싶어도.
You know, even though you want to have fun.
행복해지고 싶어도.
Even though you want to become happy.
돈이 없어 못하는 사람들이 많은데.
There are many people who don't have the money to do those things.
돈이 있으니까.
But now she had the money.
돈으로 쾌락을 살려고 했어.
She wanted to buy pleasure with money.
돈으로 내 즐거움을 살려고 했어.
She wanted to buy enjoyment with money.
돈으로 행복을 살려고 했어.
She wanted to buy happiness with money.
돈을 가진 사람들의 마음이 달려가는 항상 그쪽이에요.
And the people with lots of money hearts tend to flow in that direction.
건전하게 사업을 한 사람 말고.
People who are not doing business in a healthy way.
많은 돈을 손에 잡으면.
But if you have a lot of money in your hand.
그 돈을 가지고
with that money.
쾌락으로 즐거움으로 행복하고 싶은 일을 해요.
People want to do things to fulfill their pleasures and ambitions to make themselves happy.
웃기는 이야기는.
And then what happened was.
돈을 가지고 행복 산다는 건 너무 우스운 이야기.
You know, if you have money, then you can live happily. That's a joke.
이 부인은 어떻게 된지 아십니까?
Do you know what happened to this lady?
다른 돈 많은 사람이 가는 그 길로 따라간.
She followed where all the other people with lots of money went.
불과 얼마 지나지 않아서.
And in a short amount of time,
불면증에 걸려.
She got insomnia.
잠을 잘 수 없어.
She couldn't sleep.
수면제를 하나를 먹고.
She would take one sleeping pill.
두 알을 먹고.
Two sleeping pills.
이제 수면제 먹는 양이 늘어졌네.
Now her quantity of sleeping pills grew.
신경안정제를 먹어야.
She had to take anxiety pills.
그런 일들이 있었어.
And these things started to happen.
어느 날 이 부인이 너무 어려운 범인에 잠을 자지 못.
And one day she was having difficulty sleeping one night.
새벽 두 시쯤 됐는데.
And around 2 in the morning.
누군가가 자기를 부르는 소리가 들려.
She heard a voice of somebody calling her.
귀로 듣는지 마음에 드는 그 구분이 안 가.
She couldn't tell whether she was hearing this in her ears or in her heart.
분명히 자기 마음을 끌어가고 있어.
And surely it was pulling on her heart.
너 너무 힘들지.
You're so tired, aren't you?
내가 너 편안하게 해줄게.
I'll give you good rest.
내가 너 쉬게 해줄게.
Now let me give you rest.
그 소리가 너무 너무 따뜻하게 들려.
And that voice sounded so warm.
정말 너무 다정해.
And really, it sounded so kind.
일어나.
Get up.
창 곁으로 가.
Go to the window.
창문을 열어.
And open the window.
고층 아파트에 사는 분.
She lives in a high-rise apartment.
그리고 의자를 가져와.
And go bring a chair.
창문 앞에 놓아.
And put it in front of the window.
의자 위에 올라가.
And get on the chair.
뛰어내려.
Jump out.
사람 어차피 죽는 거야.
Everybody dies anyway.
죽기 위해 사는 거야.
And we all live to die.
죽으면 모든 게 끝이야.
And once you die, everything will be over.
이 부인이 죽고 싶었어.
And she wanted to die.
딸이 있었어.
But she had a daughter.
근데 무슨 얘기를 하냐면
But the voice what it said was
너 어머니 있잖아.
You have your mother.
돈 좋아하잖아.
And she loves money.
네가 남긴 아파트 몇채 가지고
You know she can take the few apartments that you own.
너 어머니 가지고 하고 딸 잘 키워 줄 거야.
Your mother will take your apartments and raise your daughter well.
내려. 내려. 그럼 모든 끝나는 거야.
Jump out, jump out and everything will be finished.
이 부인이 저한테 얘기를 했어.
And this lady told me
만일 그날 자기 술을 마셨다.
If she had a drink that day.
만일 그는 그날 신경안정제를 먹었다.
If she had taken some anxiety pills that day.
술은 판단을 흐리게 만든다.
You know, if you drink, it clouds your judgment.
신경안정제 역시 판단을 흐리게 했기.
If you take anxiety pills, it also clouds your judgment.
자기서 뛰어내리고 싶은 충동이 일어난다.
You know, she was having these urges to jump out.
만일 술을 마셨으면 틀림없이 뛰어.
And if she had drunken that day, surely she would have jumped out.
신경안정제를 마셨으면 정말
If she had taken the anxiety pills, then she would have jumped out that day.
이 부인은
This lady,
자기 가까운 사람 가운데서
of the people that she's close with,
어느 날 갑자기 자살한 사람이 많았어.
There were lots of people around her who would suddenly commit suicide.
여행 가기로 준비 다 해놓고
they have travel plans and everything.
모든 걸 약속해놓은 비행기 투표까지 사놓고
and they have their appointments and air tickets and everything.
그 다음 날 죽은 거야.
And then they kill themselves
사람들이
suddenly.
이해를 못해서.
And people don't understand.
아, 그 언니가 이래서 죽었구나.
And she realized, ah, that's why that lady killed herself.
자기 또 후배 하나 그렇게 죽었어.
And then there was another colleague of hers who killed herself.
어떤 영이 사람의 마음을 끌어가고.
A certain spirit is dragging people's hearts.
이제 문제는
But the problem was
세상에 참 많은 책들이 있고
There are lots of books in this world.
지식들이 있지만
And there's lots of knowledge.
마음의 세계를 정확하게 그린 책
But there is no book that precisely illustrates the world
제가
of the heart.
이 성경을 읽었을 때,
But the amazing thing is when we read the Bible,
그 성경은 너무 재미가 없는 책.
The Bible is such a boring book.
대부분의 문학 서적은
the most literary
우리
works.
우리 감정을 자극해서 마음의 기쁨을 줍니다.
You know, they evoke our emotions to make us feel joy.
성경은 진리를 이야기하기 위해.
But the Bible speaks the truth.
성경치 않은 모든 감정을 다 뽑아버렸어.
All emotions in the Bible have been removed.
감정은 사람 느낌에 따라 사실하고 다른 것을 많이 만들기 때문에.
And so emotions, depending on how you feel, it brings forth many things that are untrue.
그 성경을 기록할 때 하나님은
And so when God recorded the Bible,
감정적인 문구를 다 뽑아.
God removed all emotional words.
어디에도 감정을 표현한 장면은.
There is no place in the Bible where emotion is expressed.
왜?
Why?
진리를 그대로 증거하기 위해.
Because he wanted to testify the truth as it is.
그 감정이 빠진 책이니까 흥미는 없어요.
And so it's not fun because emotions are missing from this book.
성경을 열 번쯤 읽었을 때.
But after I read the Bible about 10 times.
아 이게 우리 마음의 세계를 이야기하는 것이야.
Ah, this is talking about the world of our hearts.
그러면서 그 성경 안에서 그런 하나님의 마음을 정확하게.
And through it, I could precisely see the heart of God that was flowing inside of the Bible.
그리고 성경 안에서 또 다른 하나의 그림을 보았는데
And I saw another picture drawn inside of the Bible.
정확하게 내 마음의 모양이 거기다 기록된 걸 알
I could see precisely it illustrated the image of my heart
아,
in the Bible.
옛날에 많은 사람들이 말하기를
And many people would say
성경은 마음의 거울이라고 말했는데
That the Bible is the mirror of the heart.
아, 이래서 마음의 거울이라고 말해
Ah, so that's why it's called the mirror of the heart.
제가 이제 성경을 읽으면서
And as I would read the Bible
내 마음을 봤는데
I looked at my heart.
내 마음은 하나님 마음과 너무 멀리 있던.
My heart was so far from the heart of God.
그래서 불행했구나.
Ah, that's why I was miserable.
알게 됐어.
I came to realize it.
그러면 제가 하나님하고 나하고 마음을 맞추어가기.
And I began to match my heart with the heart of God.
놀라운 일들이 일어나.
And amazing things started to happen.
하나님 마음이 내 마음에 흐르면.
And as the heart of God flowed into my heart.
전에 없는 평안이 내 마음에 들어왔어.
A peace I never had before entered my heart.
전에 없는 거룩함이 내 속에 살아 일하는 거.
Holiness I never had before began to live and work in my heart.
하나님 내 안에 살아 능력으로 일하는 걸 봤어.
And I saw God living and working with power within me.
굉장히 많은 어려움이 있었지만
And although I had many hardships,
새로운 그 마음들이 그걸 이길 힘이 됐어.
Those new hearts became the power for me to overcome these things.
이제 실제로 내가 말씀을 경험하는 시간
And now I began to experience the word.
해마다 대학생 1,000명을 모집합니다.
Each year we recruit 1,000 college students.
교육을 시켜가지고.
And we train them.
그중에 500명 선발해서.
And of them we select 500.
전 세계에 우리 가서 봉사들어.
And we have them go and serve all over the world.
지금까지 한 6,000여 명의 학생들을 세계 가서 1년 동안 대학을 학을 중단하고 봉사하게.
Until now, we sent about 6,000 college students go abroad and to do volunteer service.
지금도 한 8년쯤 전이라고 생각되는데.
And I think maybe it was about 8 years ago from now.
오늘 저녁에 전화가 왔어.
One day, I got a phone call.
목사님.
Pastor.
라이베리아에서 전화.
It was a phone call from Liberia.
라이베리아의 군유스코 담당하고 있는 교사가 저한테 전화.
In Liberia, the teacher who was in charge of Good News Corps called me.
목사님, 최요한이가요. 목사님, 최요한이가요. 죽어가고 있어요. 전갈에 쏘였어.
Pastor, you know John Choi? You know John Choi? Pastor, he's been stung by a scorpion and he's dying.
그날 그 이야기 잊을 수 없어.
And I could never forget those words that day.
최요한이가 그날 밤에 잠을 잤는데.
John Choi was sleeping the night before.
한밤중에 누군가 바늘을 가지고 발을 찌른다고 아!
In the middle of the night, it felt like somebody took a needle and poked his foot and he woke him up.
잠이 깨서 아무것도 없었어.
And he looked around and there was nothing.
너무 피곤해 그냥 잠이 들었어.
He was so tired he fell back asleep.
그러던 아침이었습니다.
And it became the next morning.
야, 어제 저녁에 누군가 내 발을 바늘로 찌른 것 같아.
Hey, last night I think somebody poked my foot with a needle.
형 혹시 그 전갈 아니야?
Hey brother, maybe it was a scorpion.
웃기지 마. 우리 방에 무슨 전갈이 있어?
Hey, don't joke about that. There's no scorpion in this room.
친했어.
And they just went on.
오후쯤 돼서.
And then in the afternoon,
갑자기 학생이 몸이 빡빡해졌지.
All of a sudden, his body began to stiffen.
오줌을 싸고 똥을 싸.
And he peed and pooed in his pants.
병원에 데려왔어.
And they rushed him to the hospital.
의사가 첫 마디 하는 말이.
And the first thing the doctor said was,
야, 전갈에 쏘였다.
He's been stung by a scorpion.
왜 이제 왔느냐?
Why did you come now?
전갈이 또 온 몸에 다.
The poison of the scorpion is already spread throughout his whole body.
죽는다.
He's gonna die.
어떻게 할 수가 없냐고.
Can is there anything you can do?
안 된다.
No.
전갈에 쏘이면 바로 와도 죽을 것만.
If you get stung by a scorpion, even though you come immediately, you'll die.
이미 온 몸에 독이 퍼져. 죽어.
But the poison has already spread throughout his whole body.
그리고 잠시 후에 숨이 끊어.
And then soon after, he stopped breathing.
의사들이 심폐소생술을
The doctors performed CPR and had his heart beating again.
문제는
But the problem was his blood pressure kept on falling and falling and falling.
죽어가고 있어.
He was dying.
거기에 있는 담당자가 저한테 전화했어.
And there the person in charge called me saying
울면서 전화했어.
Called me crying.
목사님, 우리 최원이가요.
Pastor, you know John Choi, you know John Choi.
제가 최원을 학생을 알아요.
And I know John Choi. He's from Dallas. And he's been stung by a scorpion. He was dying. And then I said to him, Can I talk to John on the phone? And he handed the phone to John Choi. And I started to talk to John on the phone. John, can you hear my voice?
목사님.
Yes, Pastor.
너는 아프리카산 전갈에 쏘였대.
They say you've been stung by an African scorpion.
너는 지금 죽어.
They say you're dying right now.
근데 요한아.
But John.
내 이야기 들어봐.
Listen to me.
난 오늘 아침에 성경을 읽었어.
And this morning I read the Bible.
성경 이사야 40장 31절에
In the Bible, Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31
무슨 이야기 있는지 알아?
Do you know what it says?
난 오늘 아침에 이사야 40장 31절에
And this morning, I read Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31
오직 여호와를 앙망한 자는 새 힘을 얻을
It says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
그거를
I read those words.
요한아
John
이 성경은
The Bible
66권 전부 다가 하나님의 말씀을 기록.
All 66 books of the Bible record the word of God.
물론 모세가 기록했고.
Of course, Moses wrote it.
다윗이 기록했고.
David wrote it.
이사야가 기록했고.
And Isaiah wrote it.
그랬어.
Yes.
그 사람들은 자기 생각을 기록한 게 아니고.
And but they did not record of their own thoughts.
하나님께로부터 받은 말씀을 그대로 기록했고.
But they recorded the words that they received from God exactly as it was.
성경 자체는 하나님의 말씀.
And so the Bible itself is the word of God.
그리고
and
중요한 사실은 하나님 절대 거짓말하지 않아요.
The important thing is that God, he never lies.
하나님이 뭐라고 말씀하시냐?
And so what is it that God is saying?
여호와를 앙망한 자는 새 힘을 얻는다.
They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
얼마나 좋은 이야기.
how great these words are.
하나님은 절대로 거짓말하지 않아요.
You know, God, he never lies.
하나님은 절대로 거짓말하지 않아요.
You know, God, he never lies.
하나님은 그 약속을 지켜.
And God talked to that student.
요한은 이가 증가의 독을 이기려면
I told that student, John, if you want to overcome the poison of the scorpion,
힘이 필요해.
You need new strength.
하나님을 앙망하며
And if you wait upon the Lord,
하나님을 바라보고 하나님을 기다리면
If you look to God and wait upon God,
하나님 분명히 새 힘을 주신다.
Surely God will give you new strength.
네가 만일에 하나님을 바라봐.
And if you look to God, John.
그럼 하나님은 거짓말하지 않으신 분이니까
Because God does not lie.
약속대로 너에게 새 힘을 주실 거야.
As promised, God will give you new strength.
그러면 너는 반드시 증가의 독을 이겨.
Then surely you can overcome the poison of the scorpion.
반드시 살아날 수 있어.
And you can come to life.
요한은 자기가 죽어가고 있는 걸 느꼈어요.
John, he felt that he was dying.
마지막으로 달라서 아버지가 보고 싶다.
And lastly, he thought, I want to see my father.
그리고 이제 자기가 죽지 않을 수 없었어요.
And he could not not die.
밤에 증가를 소했는데.
He was stung by the scorpion at night.
그래 밤 12시쯤 소했다고 생각했을 때.
And if he was stung around midnight.
그 이튿날 12시면은.
The next day noon.
12시간이 지난 거죠.
12 hours had passed.
그때 온 몸에 다 증가의 독이.
Right then, the poison of the scorpion had spread throughout his whole body.
증가의 독이 심장에 저 심장에 힘이 없어지니까 혈압이
The poison reached his heart and weakened his heart, and his blood pressure was falling and falling.
그때 저하고 통화가 됐어요.
And that's when I spoke with him on the phone.
저는 제가 요한이고 다른 이야기하지 않았어요.
And I didn't say anything else to John.
성경에 하나님이 어떻게 얘기하는 그 이야기.
And I told him what God says in the Bible.
그리고 제가 믿는 것은
And what I believed was
성경에 기록된 모든 하나님 말씀인데
All the words recorded in the Bible are the words of God.
하나님은 한 번도 거짓말하지 않아요.
God not once lies. God always keeps his promise.
저는 그 하나님의 약속을 믿습니다.
And so God, I believe in the promise more than the circumstances.
요한이 그때 처음으로 하나님의 약속 말씀을 깨닫게.
And right then, John, for the first time, realized the word of God.
성경에 하나님은 악마한 자는 새 힘을 준다 기록되어 있네.
The Bible says, if you wait upon the Lord, God will renew your strength.
그럼 내가 하나님을 악망하면
Everyone, if I wait upon God,
하나님 나에게 새 힘을 주시겠네.
Then God will give me new strength.
그럼 내가 증가의 독을 이길 수가 있겠네.
Then I can overcome the poison of the scorpion.
그냥 그대로 마음에 믿어봐라.
And he just simply believed it in his heart.
그 이야기가 마음 안에 돌아면서
And as those words entered his heart
마음에 절망밖에 없던 그 요한의 마음속에
In John's heart which had nothing but despair
이제 조그마한 소망이 움트기 시작
Now a small hope began to move in his heart
놀라운 게 그것입니다
And that was what was amazing
저는 지금까지 살아보면 제 삶에 많은 어려움이 있었어요
As I lived my life until now I had many difficulties
1999년 심장이 나빠서
In 1999 my heart was ill
거의 죽을 뻔한 적이 있어요
And I almost died
한국 한양대학병원에서 일주일 동안
And at the Hanyang University Hospital in Korea, they examined me for one
그
week.
심장의 병을 발견하지 못했어요.
And they could not find the sickness of my heart.
제가 청진기를 대고
I would get a stethoscope
심장을 대봐요.
And put it upon my heart.
심장이 쿵쿵 뛰다가 한쪽 뚝 서버려.
And then my heart would beat, and then it would stop.
그다가 또 다시 뛰기 시작.
And then it would start beating again.
한번 서면 그게 한 몇 초가 가는데
And so my heart would stop beating for several seconds.
기분이 아주 묘해요.
I would get a strange feeling.
다시 안 뛰면 죽잖아요.
Because if it doesn't start beating again, I'm going to die.
미국에 뉴욕에 세계 심장 체 전문가는 사람을 만났어요.
And I met a world famous cardiologist in New York.
아주 나이가 많은 분이.
And he was a very old man.
병원에서 이제 완전히 이제 퇴직한 분입니다.
And he had already retired from the hospital.
그러면서 병원에 와서 특별한 제 환자들만 봐주는.
But occasionally he would come back to the hospital to check out special patients.
그럼 저 앞에 올 때 다른 의사의 부축을 받아가지고 왔어요.
And when he came to me, other doctors had to hold him up.
제가 그분하고 12시간 동안 내 심장을 샅샅이 검사.
And then he examined my heart for 12 hours.
그분이 여러 말 하지 않았어요.
And then he didn't say much.
우리 방법으로는 이 병을 고칠 수.
He said, with our technology, we cannot heal this disease.
그리고 저는 그 병원을 나왔어요.
And then I left that hospital.
병이 점점 더 심장이 이렇게 심각해.
And the disease of my heart was getting worse and worse.
점점 더 어려워지기 시작.
And it was getting more and more difficult.
1999년
1999, in May,
제가 페루 리마 실내 체육관에서 한 주간 동안 집회를
at the indoor gymnasium in Peru, Lima, I had a conference for a week.
제가 이제 단 뒤에 앉아서 이제 다른 순서 진행도 안 돼. 내 순서가 기다.
And so I was sitting on the back waiting for the program to proceed for it to be my turn to speak.
저는 뭐 몇만 명 청중 앞에도 여러분서 했기 때문에.
And I've stood in front of tens of thousands before, type of people
before. 앞에 내가 뭐 위기감을 느끼고 그런 적은 거의 없어요.
And so I've never felt stage fright or crowd fright or anything like that.
그 실내 체육관에 그 청중을 보는데.
But in that gymnasium, as I saw the audience,
막 가슴 뛰기 시작.
My heart started to pound.
심장이 멎을 것 같아.
I felt like my heart was going to stop.
조용히 일어나서.
I quietly got up.
지하실을 내려갔어.
I went to the basement.
지하실에 선수 대기실에서.
And the basement was the players' waiting area.
한참 있다가 올라오곤 했어.
And I stayed there for a long while, and then I came back up.
밖으로 집회를 마쳤어.
And I barely got through the conference.
내가 페루 리마를 떠날 때,
when I was leaving Lima, Peru,
모든 사람이 제 공항에 저를 맞은.
Everybody came to the airport to say goodbye to me.
비행기를 타고,
I got on the airplane.
손은 들고,
I waved goodbye.
그 사람들이 돌아가면서,
and as they were leaving,
그 사람들 무슨 얘기를 했냐면,
what they said was,
이제 박 목사님은 이게 마지막이.
This is the end for Pastor Park.
우리가 다시는 얼굴을 볼 수.
We'll never see his face again.
그리고 제가 5월 달에 저희 대전에 왔어.
And that year in May, I returned to Daejeon.
우리 교회 빌딩 7층 빌딩이 있었나.
At our church, we had a 7-story building.
그 7층에서 이제 우리가 돌을 붙이는 작업을.
And at that building, we worked to apply stones on that building.
인부들이 7층 그 발판 위에 서 있는 걸 제가 볼 때 막 가슴이 뛰어서.
And I saw the workers at the 7th floor scaffolding working around and working. My heart would pound as I looked at them. I couldn't see them. Will I be able to survive 1 month like this or 2 months like this? And it became the August of that year. And we had our camp at the pine fields. And then, except for the time to give my message, I remained in my tent. But one day, a thought came to my mind. And so there, from the main area to the children's Sunday school, it's about 500 meters. But I had made 4 round trips that day. It means altogether that day I walked 4 kilometers.
아, 내가 이렇게 걸을 수 있었나?
Was I able to walk this well?
내가 병이 다 나은 것도 그렇게.
Then that means my disease is all healed.
그리고 그때부터 제가 병이 다 나았다고 믿었어.
And then from then I believed that my disease was all healed.
조깅을 시작했어.
And then I started jogging.
그리고 저희들 교회가 있는데 대전에 그 앞에 서대전 여자 고등학교가 있어.
And then we have our church, and in front of it, we have the 서대전 Women's High School in front of my church.
그 운동장에 소나무 숲을 가지고 너무 아름다워.
And their field, they have pine trees on their field, and it's very beautiful.
운동장 한 바퀴 300m.
And it's 300 meters one lap.
그러면서 조깅을 시작.
And from that day on, I started jogging.
300m 두 바퀴를 더 옆구리가 아파서 뛸 수 없어.
When I ran the 300 meter lap 2 times, my sides began to hurt.
계속 뛰었어.
But I kept on running.
1km,
1 kilometer,
2km,
2 kilometers,
3km,
3 kilometers,
4km,
4 kilometers,
5km,
5 kilometers.
매일 아침 5km를 뛰었어.
And every morning I ran 5 kilometers.
심장이 너무 좋아지는 거야.
And my heart was getting better and better.
이제 한 5km 뛰면 땀이 흐르는데.
And after 5 kilometers I would start sweating.
땀이 흐르면 그렇게 기분이 좋았어.
And it made me feel so good.
그래서 그해 8월 달에 내 심장이
And that year, August, my heart was completely healed.
심장이 좋아지면 간도 좋아지겠네.
And as my heart was healed, my liver got better.
폐도 좋아지.
My lungs also got better.
저는 수영을 잘 못하지만.
And I was not a good swimmer.
수영을 상당히 좋아.
But I started to like swimming.
강에서 여러 번 수영을 했어.
I went swimming in the river many times.
강도 여러 번 건너고.
I've crossed many rivers.
저는 수영할 때 한 번 주고 두 번 주고 숨을 쉬었나.
And then when I would swim, before I would have to breathe every stroke.
네 번을 적어 숨을 쉬어도 숨 차지가 안 나.
But now I would breathe every 4 strokes and still I was fine.
물론 내가 힘 있게 하진 않았지만.
And of course I did not stroke very hard.
하루에 한 시간씩 수영을 해도.
But I would swim 1 hour a day.
숨이 차지 않았어.
And I was not out of breath.
제가 태어나서.
Ever since I was born.
지난 17년 동안.
The last 17 years.
정말 건강하게 살았어.
Was truly the healthiest I've ever been.
저는 제가 LA에서 서울까지 오면. 완전히 지쳐서 어떡할 수가 없어.
When I would come from LA to Seoul, I would be so exhausted, I wouldn't know what to do.
제가 파라과이에서 한국 올 때
When I would come to Korea from Paraguay
파라과이 상파울로에서까지 4시간
From Paraguay to São Paulo is 4 hours
상파울로에서 LA가 13시간
From São Paulo to LA 13 hours
서울까 13시간
LA to Seoul 13 hours
비행기 타는 시간만 30시간
And the flying hours alone was 30 hours.
제가 비행기를 너무 잘 타게 됐어요.
But I became so good at riding planes.
비행기 타고 피곤하는 게 이해가 안 돼.
I couldn't understand why people get tired riding on planes.
제가 대한항공만 150만 마일 탔어요.
And I've flown about 1.5 million miles on Korean Air alone.
그래서 대한항공에 밀리언 마일을 하고.
And so I become a million miler for the Korean Air.
대한항공에 내 이름을 쳐넣으면.
And if you type up my name in Korean Air,
밀리언 마일로 표시가 나와.
It says million miler.
제 티켓은 항상 밀리언 마일로 찍혀져.
And so my ticket comes out always printed saying million miler.
저 같은 사람 대한항공 먹여 살린 사람.
And so the person like me is who's feeding Korean Air.
그래서 모든 직원들 저 항상 특별히 대접을.
And the workers there always give me special treatment.
여러분 비행기 타고 콜라 마시고
You know you drink coke while you're on the plane
낮잠 자고
take a nap
심은 책 읽고
and you read a book
전화 안 오고
and you don't get phone calls
왜 피곤한지 모르겠어
I don't know why people get tired
전부 다 저하고 다니면 막 피곤해 죽으려고
and then some people they travel with me they get so tired
정말 하나님의 그 약속을 봤어
and so I saw the promise of God at work
하나님께서 나를 고치 나와 같이 정말 느껴
And I could precisely feel how God was with me.
제가 무슨 일을 하든지 간에.
And no matter what I did.
제 앞에 어떤 어려움이 있든지 간에.
And no matter what hardship I had.
하나님의 말씀이 내 마음에 힘을.
The word of God gave me strength to my heart.
너무 너무 신기.
And that was so amazing.
우리는 푸른 곰팡이가.
The blue fungus.
우리 몸에 치명적인 악을 주는 그 포도상규균을.
You know, these fatal germs that would kill us, we never knew that the blue fungus was so effective against them.
근데 여러분, 그 포도상규균이 우리를 감염해서 우리를 죽여주는데
But those fatal germs, they infect us and they kill us.
아무것도 그걸 이길 수 없지만
Nobody could defeat them.
푸른 곰팡이가 가면 포도상 그대로 없어지는
But the blue fungus shows up, goes there and kills all those germs.
너무너무 신기한
It's so amazing.
전에는 그 상처를 고치 못 다리를 끊고 발을 끊고.
Before they couldn't heal those wounds, and they would have to amputate the legs and the arms.
다리를 끊을 수 있고 발목을 끊을 수 있지만.
You could amputate an arm or a leg.
배를 잘라낼 수 없잖아.
But you cannot amputate your belly.
병을 그 죽고.
Then people would die.
그 약 하나가 남아서.
But because of that medication.
이제 막 많은 방향으로 항생제가.
Because of that medicine, they were able to develop many kinds of antibiotics.
정말 옛날에 그 약 하나만 있으면 살을 건데.
And long time ago, if they had that medicine, many people would have lived.
약이 없어 죽은 사람 얼마나 많은지 몰라.
But so many people were dying because they did not have that medicine.
이제 우리가 이 지구에 살면서
as we live on this earth,
아는 게 모르는 게 너무 너무 많아.
There's so many things we don't know.
이야기를 했습니다만.
And I told you this, but
옛날에는 전자 제품 만드는 사람
Long time ago, people who made electronics.
여러분 그 도체 부도체가 있습니다.
There were conductors and insulators.
도체 부도체 가지고 모든 기계를 전기기를 만.
They made all machines using conductors and insulators.
어느 날 사람들이 반도체란 걸 발견했어요.
But one day, people discovered the semiconductor.
반도체는 전기가 통했다가 안 통했다가.
Semiconductors, electricity passed through them, and sometimes not.
그런 전자 제품, 전기 제품 만든 사람들이.
And people who made electronics.
지구에 제일 쓸모없는 게 반도체라고.
They thought the most useless thing in the world was semiconductors.
야 반도체야.
Semiconductors.
너 왜 그렇게 주관이 없냐?
You know why are you so uncommitted?
전기가 통하려면 통하고 말려면 말지.
If you're going to be a conductor, let it be. If not, not.
왜 통하다 말았다 그 사람이 그래 왔다 갔다 해.
But why are you on and off, on and off?
사람들이 그렇게 말해.
That's what people used to say.
사람들이 반도체 연구했어.
And then people studied the semiconductors.
그냥 전기가 통하고 안 통하는 게 아니고.
It's not just electricity would pass through them and then not pass through them.
전기가 통할 때 안 통할 때 어떤 법칙에 따라 통했다 안 통했다는 알았어.
They discovered that according to certain rules, electricity would pass through them or not pass through them.
사람들이 그거를 이용할 때.
And when people manipulate this.
너무 편리해져.
Things became very convenient.
지금은 여러분 이 지구가 돌아 반도체가 이 세상이 돌아가지 않아.
Now everyone, this world cannot run without semiconductors.
수많은 컴퓨터,
computers,
자동차,
cars,
여러 가지 핸드폰 그게도
and the cell phones that you have.
수많은 반도체가 그 핸드폰.
There are many, many semiconductors inside your phones.
그렇게 귀중한 건데.
And this is something so precious.
옛날에 그 반도체 대해 몰랐을 때는.
A long time ago, when people didn't know about semiconductors.
제일 쓸모없는 게 반도체.
That's the semiconductors, the most useless thing.
이런 게 다 있어.
Why would you want something like
this? 도와는 도와 말로 말지.
You know, if it's going to be a conductor, let it be. If not, not.
지금도 우리가 모르는 게 너무 많아.
Even now, there are so many things we don't know.
지금도 우리는 모르는 게 참 많아.
Even now, there are so many things we don't know.
그걸 알면 사람이 삶이 달라져.
And when we know, get to know these things, the way we live will change.
굉장히 과학이 발달되고.
But as science became advanced,
지식이 많아졌지만.
And there's increase in knowledge.
지금도 아는 것보다 모르는 게 훨씬 많아.
Even now, there are so many more things we don't know than what we know.
들어보세요.
Please listen.
사람의 행복이 뭡니까?
What is happiness for people?
돈이 많은 게 행복이에요.
Is it having a lot of money?
지위가 높은 게 행복이에요.
Is it having a high position?
권세 있는 게 행복이에요.
Is it having power?
명예가 있는 게 행복이에요.
Is it having honor?
그냥 사는 눈에 보기 따라서.
And when we live life, people follow what they see with their
eyes. 돈이
있으면
모든 걸 살 수 있어요. 좋아서 돈을 좋아하고.
The people love money. Yeah, if I have money, I can have everything.
지위가 높으면 편리하니까 지위 높으려고 하고.
If I have a high position, things will be comfortable.
사람들은 그렇게 합니다.
And that is what people pursue.
근데 여러분 그것으로 마음의 행복을 살 수 있나요?
But with that, can you buy happiness for your heart?
말도 안 되는 이야기.
That's nonsense.
행복을 느끼는 건 마음입니다.
It is the heart that feels the happiness.
맞습니까?
Is that right?
마음.
It is the heart.
고통을 느끼는 것도 마음입니다.
Also, it is the heart that feels the pain.
마음이 그냥 불규칙하게 만드신 게 아닙니다.
The heart was not formed disorderly.
1984년 5년, 6년부터 시작해서
From 1984, 85, 86 at Suwon Prison
그 재소자들을 가르쳤어요.
I taught the inmates there.
성경을 가르쳤어요.
I taught them the Bible.
매주 월요일 1시에 교도소에 갑니다.
Every Monday at 1 p.m. I would go to the prisons.
그래서 이제 그 재소자 모아놓고
And I would gather the inmates
성경을 가르쳐 이야기
And I would teach them the Bible and speak to them.
제가 매주 월요일마다 교도소에 가요.
And every Monday, I would go to the prisons.
처음에 교도소 갔을 때,
when I first started going,
아, 저 사람 내 신문에 봤는데.
Oh yeah, I saw that guy in the newspaper.
그분이 여기 와 있구나.
Oh, he's here.
아, 저 사람 저 살인자.
Oh yeah, that guy, that murderer.
그것밖에 안 보였어요.
That was all that I could see.
제가 교도소 1년 동안 일을 했을 때,
but after working for the prison for 1 year,
정확히 아는 것은,
what I could clearly see was,
교도소에 가는 사람이 어떤 사람이 가는 참.
I could clearly see what kind of people end up going to prisons.
교도는 악한 사람이 가는 거 절대 아닙니다.
And it's not the wicked people who end up going to prisons.
미안하지만
I'm sorry to say
악한 사람 교도소 안 갑니다.
It's not the evil people who go to prison.
그 사람 악한 사람 악을 저지른 법을 먼저 알기 때문에.
And the people they're evil, so they know the law.
이렇게 하면 교도 갈 거라 압니다.
They know if I do this, it's going to take me to prison.
그 악을 저지른 법에 맞지 안 법에 안 걸리게.
And so they commit evil to be not caught by the law.
그래서 여러분 악하다 교도한다 말은 말이 안 맞습니다.
And so do you go to prison because you're evil? That doesn't make any sense.
제가 1년 동안 교도소 가서 사람들을 만났어요.
And I met with the people in prisons for 1 year.
제가 만난 대부분의 사람 살인자들.
And most of the people that I met were murderers.
중형자들이.
And they were violent criminals.
1년 동안 가서 그들의 성경을 가지고 그들의 대화도 하고.
And I talked the Bible to them for 1 year. I spoke with them and I heard from them how they committed their crimes. Right then I realized it's decided what kind of people go to prison. People who have the heart that could only have them be taken to prison. And when do people get divorced?
아, 우리 남편은 너무 악해요. 그래 같이 살 수 없어요.
Oh, my husband is so evil. I cannot live with him.
아, 내 아내는 너무 고집이 세요. 도저히 같이 못 살아요.
Oh, my wife is so stubborn. I can never live with her.
매일 나를 괴롭혀요.
She picks on me every day.
이혼한 사람은 그렇게 말해.
People who get divorced, that's what they say.
그런데요.
But
어려워도 이혼한 사람.
There are people who don't get divorced even though there is difficulties.
이혼한 사람이 갖는 마음은 대부분 예외도 없진 않지만
There are exceptions but there are certain hearts that people have that lead them to divorce.
여러분 제가 이제 마음의 세계를 성경에 배우면서 이야기해서
And as I would explain the world of the heart
마음을 어떻게 했을 때 어떻게 하는 그걸 정확히
And so I could clearly see what your heart, which way it flows, and how it becomes what.
제가 1995년에
In 1995,
미국 LA에 있는
In LA,
어떤 부인을 만났어요.
I met a certain lady in LA.
그 부인이 전에부터 아는 부인이었는데.
And this was a lady I had known for a long time.
내가 LA에 온 걸 알고 그분은 저를 찾아왔습니다.
She heard that I came to LA and she came to see me.
그분은 LA에 와서 남편하고 불행하게 이혼을 했어요.
And she came to LA and unfortunately she got divorced from her husband in LA.
그리고 이제 어린 아들 하나를 데리고 키웠어요.
And she was raising her young son.
제가 회계사 시험을 쳐가지고
And then she took the CPA exam
합격을 했습니다.
And she passed.
우리 큰 식당 세금 계산해 주고
And she did taxes for large restaurants in LA.
비교적 삶이 여유가 있어요.
And she had pretty good income.
그 어머니는 자기 아들이 삶의 전부였어요.
And so for her, her son was everything.
아들이 많은 걸 했어요.
And she did many things for her son.
어머니 마음의 세계를 모르니까.
And the mother, she doesn't know the world of the heart.
백화점 바지를 살 때.
When she bought pants at the shopping mall.
제일 좋은 거.
She bought the best ones.
사과를 살 때.
When she bought apples.
제일 비싼 거.
The most expensive.
뭘 하든지.
No matter what she bought.
자기 아들을 최고로 사줬.
She only bought the best for her son.
그게 자기 아들을 잘 키우는 건 줄 알고.
And she thought that was the best way to raise her son.
문제가 생겼어.
But problems happened.
아들 15, 16대면서.
Her son became 15, 16 years old. And he started doing drugs.
어떤 날 손에 권총을 차고 있어.
And sometimes he'd be carrying a pistol.
어머니 너무 불안했어.
And the mother felt so afraid.
어머니가 저한테 왔습니다.
And then the mother came to me.
제 아들을 도와주십시오.
Please help my son.
한국에 있고 걔는 미국인데 어떻게 도울 수 있어?
I live in Korea. He's in America. How can I help him?
제가 도와줄 수 없었어.
I could not help him.
그 부인이 세 번 찾아왔는데.
And that lady came to me three times.
세 번째는 저한테 울면서.
And the third time she was crying when she said to me.
엄마가 얘기했습니다.
And then the mother said to me.
인디야.
Andy.
넌 나의 전부야.
She said to her son, "You're my everything."
내가 여러분 죽고 싶었어.
Many times I wanted to die.
하지만 너 때문에 죽을 수 없어.
But because of you, I didn't die.
인디야.
Andy.
너 그렇게 살지 않으면 안 돼.
Can you not live like this?
꼭 그렇게 살아야만 해.
Do you have to live like this?
아들이 말했어요.
Her son said.
엄마,
Mom,
그러지 마.
Don't say that.
나 살고 싶어 사는 줄 알아?
You think I live because I want to live?
나 아니야.
I don't.
나 하루에도 여러 번 죽고 싶어.
You know, many times I just wanted to die.
근데 마음대로 안 돼.
But I can't help this.
왜 엄마까지 날 괴롭혀?
Mom, why do you have to talk to me like this?
엄마 어떻게 할 수 없어?
And there was nothing the mother could do.
세 번째 와서 울면서 그 이야기.
And the third time she came to me crying, telling me about this.
제가 아이를 도와주고 싶은 방법을 찾았어.
And I looked for a way for me to help her son.
도와야겠다고 생각했어.
And I thought I needed to help her.
방법을 찾았어.
And I looked for a way.
엄마한테 얘기했어.
And I told the mother.
당신 아들.
Your son.
내가 한국에 데려가고 싶은데 괜찮아요?
Is it okay for me to take him with me to Korea?
아, 데려가라고.
She said, take him.
아이를 한국에 데려가.
And so I brought him with me to Korea.
그날부터 우리 집에 이상한 손님이 왔어.
And from that day, I had a strange guest in my home.
머리 무지개 컬러.
Rainbow-colored hair.
다 떨어진 바지 궁둥이 중.
In a torn-up pants, barely hanging off his bottom, walking around like this.
여러분 그런 사람 들어 있었죠.
You know, you've seen people like that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
제가 그 학생을 보면서.
As I saw this student.
저게 좋은 건가?
I thought, does he like being this way?
저보다 더 좋은 게 없을까?
Does he know nothing better than this?
저 학생이 저 삶을 바꾸려면 저보다 더 좋은 게 있어야 하는.
For him to change his life, he needs something better than this.
뭐가 저 학생을 저보다 좋게 할 수 있어?
No, what can make him better than this?
저는 한 번도 그런 학생들의 삶을 이해할 수 본 적이 없어.
I've never once understood the lives of these kinds of students.
안 할 수도 없고 같이 안 살 수도 없는.
And I cannot not understand him, nor could I not live with him.
그래서 제가 마음의 세계를 이야기하기.
And I began to speak to him about the world of the heart.
뭐 시간을 제놓고 그냥 틈이 있을 때만 한 번씩 마음이란 건 어떻게.
And whenever I had time, I would explain to him about the world of the heart.
어느 날.
And one day.
예수님에 대한 이야기를 했어.
I spoke to him about Jesus.
우리 죄를 위해 죽으신 이야기.
Jesus, how he died for our sins.
어느 날 깜짝 놀랐어.
And then he was shocked. He got a nice clean haircut. He put on a nice clean shirt. Nice clean pants. And he was smiling. He was so handsome. And he's very handsome. And 3 months later, he was changed 180 degrees.
지금도 만나면 얘기해.
Even now I see him occasionally.
목사님 저 그때 너무 행복.
He says, Pastor, back then I was so happy.
그때로 돌아가고 싶어.
He says, I want to go back to that time.
그 이야기.
He tells me that.
이혼한 아버지가 찾아왔어요.
The father that was divorced, he came to see him.
아들이 아버지한테 얘기했어요.
The son said to his father,
아빠 행복하세요.
Father, are you happy?
저 너무 행복해.
I'm so happy.
아빠 내 가방에 다 뜯어진 바지 있어.
Father, in my bag are the torn up pants.
이제 그것도 필요하지 않아.
And I don't need them anymore.
아빠도 행복했으면 좋겠어.
Father, I hope that you too could be happy.
아빠 예수님 믿으세요.
Father, believe in Jesus.
그 아버지 엉엉 울었어요.
And the father cried and cried.
막 뛰어갔다 나오더니.
And he ran somewhere and came back.
내가 돈을 찾아왔어.
He went to the bank and took some money.
목사님 제가 할 수 있는 이것밖에 없습니다.
And he told me, Pastor, this is all I have.
고맙단 말하고.
I want to say thank you.
이것밖에 드릴게요.
And this is all I can give you.
봉투를 주고 왔어.
He gave me an envelope.
전 주고 받아요.
And if you give it, I take it.
뇌물법에 안 걸리지 않도록.
You know, it's not bribery, so I take it.
6개월 후에 그 아이는 미국 돌아왔어.
And 6 months later, he returned to America.
LA로 왔는데.
He returned to LA.
그 주위에는 한국 교포들 깜짝 놀랐어.
And the Korean Americans in that community were shocked.
어떻게 앤디가 저럴 수가 있었지?
How could Andy change so much?
어떻게 아이가 저렇게 변할 수?
How could he change so much?
그래서.
So.
그 이듬해 여름 방학 때.
The next summer vacation.
LA에 그 학생 주위에는 한국인 교포 학생들 28명이. 한 달 동안 여름 방학 동안 저희들 교회를 방문했어요.
28 Korean American students from that community came and stayed at my church for 1 month during the summer vacation.
그게 제가 청소년 위해서 일하기 시작한 동기였어요.
And that became the starting point of my work with the youths.
제가 한 달 동안 학생들 데리고
And with the students for 1 month,
강릉 경포대도 가고
I would take them to Gyeongpo-dae in Gangneung,
제주도 가고,
to Jeju Island.
여행도 하고,
we traveled together.
틈틈이서 마음의 세계들을 이야기했어요.
And whenever I had time, I would speak to them about the world of the heart.
그리고 한 달 후에 미국으로 돌아갔어요.
And then 1 month later, they would go back to America.
이래 돌아갔는데 많은 아빠가 저한테 전화했어요.
After they returned to LA, many fathers called me.
목사님, 제 아들이 변했어요.
Pastor, my son has changed.
제 아들이 너무너무 달라졌어요.
My son has changed so much.
감사해요.
Thank you.
수시로 그런 전화를 받았어요.
We got so many phone calls like that.
제가 너무너무 행복했어요.
And I was so happy.
제가 목사 생활하면서
As I live my life as a pastor,
그렇게 행복할 수 없어요.
And I couldn't be any happier.
숫자가 많아졌어요.
And then the number grew.
2001년에는
And then in 2001,
저희 교회를 찾아온 사람들이
the people,
학생들이
the students who came to my church
500명이나 됐어요.
It was 500.
이제 미국에서 모는 게 아니고
And now they don't just come from America
다른 여러 나라에서
but from many other countries too.
한국에서 찾아왔어요.
They all came to Korea.
전 그들을 행복하게 해주고 싶어.
And I wanted to make them happy.
행복하게 해주려고 여러 가지 연구를 했어.
And I studied many things to make them happy.
아르던 합창단도 만들고.
And we made a choir.
제가 좋은 음식을 먹이자고 했어.
And I wanted to give them good food.
비싼 음식은 아닐지라도.
Even though the food is not expensive.
귀한 학생 좋은 음식을 먹이자.
We wanted to give them precious food.
그들을 행복하게 해주자.
And let us make them happy.
교사들을 세웠어.
And we got teachers.
학생들이 뭘 기뻐하는지 연구해봐.
And we studied what makes the kids happy.
학생들 어떻게 하면
What can we do to make the students satisfied?
학생들이 기쁘게 해줘라.
And let's make the students joyful.
기쁨은 고통을 이긴다.
And joy overcomes pain.
기쁨은 절망을 이긴다.
Joy overcomes despair.
기쁨은 슬픔을 이긴다.
Joy overcomes sadness.
차이는 있지만.
There are differences.
저희 캠프 온 학생들 대부분 변했어.
But most of the students who come to our camp, they changed.
이젠 세계에. 수많은 나라에 우리 IYF가 일을 하고 있어요.
Now the IYF is working in many countries invited by many governments.
그렇게 시작이 됐어요.
And that was our beginning.
저는 지금도
And even now
마음의 세계를 이야기합니다.
I speak the world of the heart.
제가 배운 마음의 세계는 전부 이 성경에서 비롯됐어요.
The world of the heart that I learned all came from the Bible.
한 분은 예수님께서
One time Jesus
가늠한 여자를 만났습니다.
He met the woman taken in the act of adultery.
가늠하다
And she was caught in the act.
고래마에 죽을 수밖에 없어.
And she was about to be stoned to death.
이제 사람들이 예수님께 들어왔어.
But people came near Jesus.
여자 가늠하다 현장 잡혔습니다.
Jesus, this woman was taken in the act of adultery.
모든 율법은 돌로 치라고 말했어.
Moses and the law commanded that such should be stoned.
성경은 어떻게 말해?
But what sayest thou, Master?
예수님 손가락에 땅에 글씨를 쓰세요.
And Jesus with his finger wrote on the ground.
그리고 너희 중에 죄 없는 자가 먼저 돌로 치라.
And let him that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone.
그 이야기 듣고 사람들이 부끄러워 자기 죄를 기억하며 다 도망갔어.
Upon hearing this, people felt so ashamed. They remembered their own sins and they all left.
예수님 그 여자를 살려서 돌려보냈어.
But Jesus saved this woman and sent her away.
이야기 내용은 아주 단순했어.
This is a very simple story.
이게 내용이 답니다.
And we all know this story.
저는 그 이야기를 읽으면서
But while reading the story,
여자의 마음을 그려봤어.
I imagined this woman's heart.
가늠하다 잡혀서 돌에 맞아 죽기가 끌려가고 있어.
She was caught in the act of adultery, being dragged to be stoned to death.
예수님을 만나기 전에 그 여자의 마음을 그려봤어.
I imagined her heart before she meets Jesus.
돌에 맞아 두려웠습니다.
She was afraid of being stoned.
절망적이었어.
She was in despair.
소망이 없습니다.
She had no hope.
그 여자 마음 어디 기쁨이 있었겠어?
There was no joy in her heart whatsoever.
아무 두려움과 절망밖에.
She had nothing but fear and despair.
예수님을 만났어.
And then she met Jesus.
그리고 예수님이 그 여자 살려줬어.
And Jesus saved this woman.
그리고 집으로 돈을 보냈어.
And he sent her away.
똑같은 여자의 마음.
Although it's the same woman's heart.
집으로 돌아갈 때 그 여자의 마음을 그려봤어.
I imagined her heart on her way home.
마음을 찍을 수 사진기가.
If there's a camera that could take a picture of her heart.
죽어서 찍어서.
You know, I want to take a picture of her heart.
노트북에 넣어놓고 싶었어.
And put it in my laptop.
조금 전에는 절망밖에 없습니다.
Earlier, she had nothing but despair.
슬픔밖에.
She had nothing but sadness.
두려움밖에.
She had nothing but fear.
예수님 만나고 짧은 시간.
But in that short time of meeting Jesus,
그 여자 마음에 말할 수 없는 감사가 있는.
In her heart now, she has unspeakable thankfulness.
사람이 감사한 마음이 있어.
When people have the thankful heart,
남을 위해서 희생할 수 있는 마음도 같이 있어.
They, along with the heart, get to have the heart to sacrifice for others.
기쁜 마음이 있으면,
when people have the joyous heart,
슬픈 자 마음 속에 있는 슬픔을 쫓아낼 수 있는 마음도 같이.
They also have the heart to kick out the sadness in others' hearts.
행복한 마음이 있으면,
when you have the heart of happiness,
고통을 이길 수 있는 마음도 같이.
You also get the heart to overcome pain.
마음의 세계가 그런 거.
And that's how the world of the heart works.
그렇구나.
Ah, that's right.
예수님 만났을 때.
When she met Jesus,
만나지 않았을 때,
and before she met Jesus,
이렇게 마음이 다르구나.
That's how different her heart is.
아무리 고통 속에 절망 속에 있던 사람이,
no matter how much pain or despair you may be in,
예수님 다른 일을 하지 아니하고,
Jesus doesn't do anything else.
우리 마음에 어두운 마음, 절망적인 마음을 내쫓고,
He kicks out the despair and the darkness from our hearts.
우리 마음에 소망과 기쁨을 주는 분이구나.
And He gives us hope and joy into our hearts.
그냥 성경 이야기를 했어.
And so we talked about, I told them about the Bible.
그냥 성경 이야기를 했어.
And we just talked about the Bible.
뭐 어떻게 해라, 어떻게 그렇게 하지 않았어.
We didn't tell the students, do this, do that, do this, do that.
이런 캠프를 마치고 나면,
But after we finished this kind of a camp,
많은 학생들이 변한 거죠.
Many students have testimonies of change.
자살하려고 했던 학생들도 있고,
students who are going to commit suicide.
아버지를 죽이려고 한 학생들도 있고,
students who are going to kill their fathers.
마약 중독자도 있고,
students who are drug addicts.
게임 중독자도 있고,
students who are game addicts.
자폐증 환자들도 있고,
students who suffer from powerlessness.
놀라운 것은,
amazing thing was,
그들의 마음에 새 마음이 들어갔을 때,
when the new heart entered into them,
예수님의 말씀은 그들 마음에 소망과 기쁨과 평안을
The words of Jesus brought their hearts joy, peace, and hope.
여러분 그 어둠은 빛이 이기는 겁니다.
Everyone, the darkness is defeated by light.
빛이 아닌 그 어느 것도 어둠을 내쫓을 수.
Without light, there's nothing that can get rid of darkness.
총을 쏘아서 어둠을 내쫓지 못.
You cannot shoot a gun to get rid of darkness.
칼로 찔러서 어둠을 내쫓을 수.
You cannot stab the darkness.
어둠을 쫓을 수 있는 건 빛밖에 다른 게.
It is only the light that can get rid of darkness.
참 많은 사람이 어둠 속에 고통하고 있어.
And so many people are suffering in darkness.
근데 어둠을 어떻게 내쫓을 줄 모르기.
But they don't know how to get rid of the darkness.
1년 동안 어둠에 있고.
And all year long they're in darkness.
5년 동안.
For 5 years.
10년 동안.
For 10 years.
세상을 원망하고.
They blame the world.
불평하고.
They complain.
어둠 속에 사는.
And they live in darkness.
예수님은 그런 사람 마음에다.
Jesus in such people's hearts.
희망을 심어줬어.
He plants hope in them.
어둠이 물러가게 했습니다.
And he lets the darkness disappear.
IYF가
The IYF.
세계에서 가장 많이 활동하는 청소년 단체로.
It's the most active youth organization in the world.
저희들이 인정을 받고 있어요.
That's how we recognize that.
왜요?
Why?
우리는 학생들을 행복하게 해줘.
We make the students happy.
성경 말씀 소망을 그다지.
And with the words of the Bible, we put hope in their hearts.
예수님의 마음을 심습.
And we plant the heart of Jesus inside of them.
어떤 사람 돈이 산더미처럼 있어 행복하지 않습니다.
You know, some people, even though they have piles of cash, they're not happy.
그러면 골치 아픕니다.
You know, then you get headaches.
그렇죠.
Right?
돈 산더미처럼 있으면.
If you had a mountain pile of money,
저거 어떻게 지키지?
How am I going to protect all this?
강도 오면 어떡하지?
What if a thief comes?
훔쳐가면 어떡하지?
What if somebody steals
어떻게
this?
어떻게 보호하지?
How am I going to protect this?
번호대로 뭐라 하지?
You know, what am I going to do with this money?
그렇겠죠.
That's what would happen.
예수님의 마음이
the heart of Jesus
우리 마음에 비친 걸 알았어.
When we know that that is the light in our hearts.
오늘도
And today as well, in John chapter 5, in the story of the man with the infirmity for 38 years,
그 사람이 가진 생각, 예수님의 생각이 달랐어.
And the thoughts that he had and the thoughts of Jesus were different.
Bethesda 연못이 있는데,
and there was the pool of Bethesda,
천사가 한 번씩 내려와서,
and the angel would come down occasionally
물을 소용돌이 치게
and cause a whirlpool in the water.
소용돌이 칠 때 어떤 병을 떼더라면 다 나았어.
And when he would trouble the water, a person who jumps in could be healed of whatever disease he had.
그 호수에는
and at that pool,
병자들만 가득히 모였어.
Many sick people were gathered.
병자 가운데 두 가지 종류의 병자.
And among the sick people, there are two kinds.
물이 동할 때,
when the water is troubled,
뛰어들어갈 수 능력 가진 병자들.
People who have the ability to jump in the water.
물가에 앉아서,
they are near the water.
못을 쳐다봅니다.
And staring at the pool.
그리고
And they're ready to jump in.
이 병자는
But the sick man here,
물이 동하는 걸 봐도
even though he sees the water being troubled,
스스로 들어갈 수 없어.
He cannot get in on his own.
누가 넣어줄 사람도 없어.
He needed somebody to put him in.
그래서 그냥 한쪽 구석에서 지난 사람 손을 내 빵 좀 하나 먹고
So he would just sit in the corner, stretch out his hand, asking for food.
목욕을 했겠습니까?
Do you think he bathed?
옷을 빨았겠습니까?
Do you think he would wash his clothes?
화장실을 갈 수 있어.
Do you think he would use the bathroom?
문자가 더 더럽고 추하게 지내고 있어.
He lived so filthy and so dirty.
예수님 그 병자를 따랐어.
But Jesus came to the sick man.
그리고 말씀했어.
And Jesus said to him,
일어나.
Rise.
내 자리를 들고 걸어가.
Take up your bed and walk.
그 이야기에서
In these words, this is the answer to solve many problems.
왜요?
Why?
예수님 말씀하셨어요.
Jesus said,
난 일어나 걸어갈 수가 있어.
You can get up and walk.
일어나 잘들어 걸어가.
Rise, take up your bed and walk.
그렇게 예수님 말씀하셨어요.
And that's what Jesus said.
일어나 내 자리를 들고 걸어.
Rise, take up your bed and walk.
병자의 생각은 어땠습니까?
The sick man, what did he think?
나는 걸을 수 없어.
I cannot do that.
난 다리가 다 말랐어.
My legs are all withered.
난 못 걸어.
I cannot walk.
예수님의 생각 우리 생각 항상 달라.
The thoughts of Jesus and our thoughts are always different.
거기서 모든 문제 해결이.
Right then, all the problems are solved.
나를 믿느냐, 예수님 말씀을.
Do you believe in yourself or do you believe the word of Jesus?
병자가 자기를 믿으면.
If the sick man believed in himself,
뭐라고 말할까?
What would he say?
예수님 저 못 걸어가요.
Jesus, I cannot walk.
걸어가려고 해봤어요.
I've tried to walk.
안 돼요.
It didn't work.
제 다리 다 말랐어요.
My legs are all withered.
일어났다 넘어지면 다칠 거예요.
If I get up, I'm going to get hurt.
안 돼요.
No.
그러니까 빵 조금 하나 주세요.
So just give me a piece of bread.
돈이나 몇 푼 주세요.
Just give me a little bit of money.
그저 그렇게 말하셨어요.
That's what he would say.
자기는 도저히 걸어갈 수 없다고 알고 있는데.
And he knows that he cannot walk at all.
예수님의 말씀은
But the words of Jesus were different from us.
자기를 믿는 사람 자기 생각을 따라 살고.
People who believe in themselves will only follow their own thoughts.
우리 인간 가운데 지혜로운 사람일수록.
But the more wise you are,
자기를 믿지 않는 삶을 삽니다.
The more he does not believe in himself.
왜냐하면 자기 삶을 뒤로 돌이켜 보면.
Because when he looks back upon his life,
우리 인간들의 삶은 너무 더럽고 추하고.
The lives of us humans are so filthy and dirty.
믿을 만은 하지 못해.
It cannot be believed in.
그러나 어리석은 사람들은.
But the foolish people.
자기를 믿어.
They trust themselves.
이 병자는.
The sick man.
38년 병 때문에 고통하고.
He was in the sickness for 38 years.
자기를 깊이 생각했어.
And he thought deeply about himself.
자기가 믿을 수 없는 인간.
He realized that he could not be believed in.
그렇다면.
If so.
내 볼 때 말이 안 되지만.
Then even though it doesn't make any sense to me,
저분은 날 보고 일어나 자리를 들고 걸어.
He tells me to take up my bed and walk.
거기서 이제 모든 게 결정.
And right then, everything is decided.
내 판단을 믿느냐.
Will you believe in your own judgment?
하나님의 판단을.
Or will you believe in the judgment of God?
성경에 말합니다.
The Bible tells us.
내 생각은 너희 생각 다르다고 하나님 말씀.
God says my thoughts are not your thoughts.
하나님보다 더 똑똑한 사람들은
And people who think they're smarter than God
자기 생각을 따라 살.
They live following their own thoughts.
하나님보다 자기 부족하다고 느끼는 사람.
But people who know that they have shortcomings before God
자기 생각을 버리고 하나님 말씀을 따라.
They throw their own thoughts away and believe the word of God.
병자가
The sick man
그랬습니다.
That's how he was.
자기를 믿을 수 없
Because he could not trust himself,
예수님 말씀을 믿었어.
He believed the words of Jesus,
자기 생각보다.
and through his own thoughts
away. 자기는 분명히 걸을 수 없는 사람인가?
And surely he cannot walk.
발은 다 다리는 말라버려.
And his legs were all withered.
힘이 없는데.
And there's no strength.
분명히 아는데.
And he knows this surely.
저분은 나를 보고 걸어갔어.
He told me to walk.
저분의 의견이 나하고 달라.
And his opinion is different from mine.
내가 내 생각을 따를 거니 저분의 말을 따를.
Will I follow my own thoughts or believe in his words?
병자 생각.
And the sick man thought.
내가 잘난 게 뭐가 있어?
What's so great about me?
근데 내가 옳다고 생각을 했지.
Why did I think that I was so right?
이제 내 마음에 안 맞지만.
Now, although this does not fit my heart.
저분의 말씀 한번 들어보자.
Let me listen to his words.
저분의 말씀을 따라보자.
Let me follow his words.
이 생각이
that thought
인간들의 생각 가장 높은 차원의 생각
is the highest level of the thoughts of man.
아십니까?
Do you understand?
그러면 여러분 예수님이 일하죠.
Then everyone, Jesus can work inside of you.
사람들은
people
많은 사람들은
many people
자기 생각이 옳다고 믿습니다.
They believe their own thoughts to be right.
예수님의 생각보다
more than the thoughts of Jesus.
하나님 말씀보다
more than the word of God.
자기 생각 옳다고.
They believe their own thoughts to be more
자기를
right.
따라갑니다.
And people follow themselves.
멸망으로 갑니다.
And it leads them to destruction.
절망으로 갑니다.
Leads them to despair.
그러나
but,
성경이 얘기하는 것은
what the Bible tells us is
이 병자는
this sick man
아무것도 할 수 없는 사람이
he was a man who could do nothing at all.
하나 아는 게 있어.
But one thing he knew was
적어도 내 생각보다 예수 생각이 옳아.
At least more than my thoughts, the thoughts of Jesus are right.
적어도 내 견해보다 하나님의 뜻이 옳아.
More than my opinions, the will of God is right.
그들은 하나님의 뜻 앞에 자기 생각을.
And he threw his own thoughts away before the will of God.
오늘 이 병자 가진 그 마음.
The heart that the sick man had today.
그 마음을 가진 병자는.
The heart, the sick man who had this heart.
예수님 능력으로 그 병에서 고침을 받.
Through the power of Jesus, he was healed from the sickness.
자리를 들고 걸어갔습니다.
He was able to take up his bed and walk.
걸어가다 보니까
and as he walked,
몸이 건강해졌으니까
his body became well.
직장을 갖게 됐고
and he got to have a job.
돈을 벌게 되고
and make money.
집을 사고
buy a house.
말도 사고
buy a horse.
술에도 사고
and buy cart.
결혼도 하고
get married.
아들 딸도 놓고
have sons and daughters.
그 말씀 아마 들은 것이
by listening to this one word,
삶을 완벽하게 바꿨.
It completely changed his life.
오늘 많은 사람들이
many people today
성경보다
rather than the Bible
하나님 말씀보다
rather than the word of God
자기 생각이 옳다고
they believe their own thoughts to be right
자기 생각에 빠져 벗어나지 못한
they fall to their own thoughts and they cannot break free
성경이 우리에게 얘기하는 것은
and what the Bible tells us is
하나님 우리 속에 일하길 원하시
God wants to work inside of us
누구에게
in whom
자기보다 하나님을 믿는
people who believe in God more than themselves.
물론 우리 생각하는 생각이 다.
Of course our thoughts and God's thoughts are different.
여러분에게 물어보십시오.
I want to ask you.
여러분 생각을 따를 것입니까?
Will you follow your own thoughts?
하나님 말씀을 따르겠습니까?
Or will you follow the word of God?
만약 여러분 여러분 생각을 버리고
if you throw these thoughts away
하나님 말씀을 믿음으로 받으리
and if you accept the word of God by faith
38년 된 병자 일하는 그 역사가
then the works of the man with the infirmity for 30 years getting up
여러분 속에도 살아서 일할
it will all live and work inside of you as well. Let us pray.
하나님 아버지 감사합니다.
Father God, we thank you.
이 자리에 있는 우리 모두에게
to all of us who are here.
우리 지식보다 하나님 높이게 주옵소서.
Let us exalt God more than our own knowledge.
38년 된 병자처럼
like the man with the infirmity for 30 years.
버리고,
let us throw our thoughts away.
하나님 말씀을 받으리게.
And let us accept the word of God.
주님 앞에 감사드립니다.
And we thank you, Lord.
하나님 복이 임하길 바랍니다.
Lord, may the blessings of God be upon us.
예수님 이름으로 기도합니다.
In the name of Jesus we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
여러분 감사합니다.
Thank you everyone.